A story about a downtown going through some major changes. Barrie is the city the granite industry created, and now the city is giving away some of that prized stone for free. News Channel 5's Jack Thurston reports.
Carol Garland is digging.
There we go.
For buried treasure.
Another one.
The Barrie, Vermont homeowner is one of well over 100 who have picked through this mountain of earth and rock over the past few weeks.
I took a day off from work to do this.
She's looking for historic granite cobblestones to make repairs to her property and build a patio.
It's a lot of elbow grease, too.
This is where all those cobblestones came from, Main Street in Barrie. They were unearthed during the city's big revitalization project. $18 million will pay for new sewer lines, sidewalks, and streetlights through the business district.
In peeling back the layers of asphalt, the workers are finding tens of thousands of hand-shaped granite blocks from the early 1900s that once paved the main drag.
So I think it's great that we're recycling them.
Mayor Tom Lozon says rules governing the federal highway funds used for the project meant the cobbles had to go in favor of approved building materials. But he couldn't stand the thought of them going to waste. So folks can check in with City Hall and sign a form to take away stones free. They just have to promise not to sell them or hoard them.
It's personally important to me that people get to enjoy them.
It's first come, first served, but with priority given to Barrie taxpayers.
I think it's exciting.
Dan Jones took a trunk full to create a border for some new shrubs he planted outside his Maplecroft bed and breakfast, an old home built by a granite executive.
When I heard that they were available, I thought, wow, what better way to kind of honor him.
With Barrie's big dig continuing all summer, thousands of more cobblestones are sure to turn up. Carol Garland can use the money she saved on building materials to entertain on her new granite patio.
It's going to be really nice.
In Barrie, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.